Hey, fellas, it's me, Rika. The real-life things were actually recorded in pouring rain. So, you know what that means? You want a little sneak peek of the audio again? Yeah, that wasn't very pleasant, was it? So, can't actually really hear me. So, I'm dubbing over it. But what happens is, I pull up in a cane, because, you know, I haven't uploaded since last decade, haha. And, I start, breaking this old headset as opposed to the keyboard. And, you know, I mentioned how a Roblox library has been kind of blowing up recently. You know, Shiletsky tweeted about it. I think Kaneko Kitten made a video about it. And that's about it for this intro. Just kind of doing my usual rambling thing. Maybe a little quip here and there. And, yeah, I'm just going to skip straight ahead to the review portion because this was the worst filming session of all time. Welcome to Roblox Building, library to Roblox Library, a vast sea of brick game knowledge, which I hope you'd appreciate more than this new Lamborghini that I bought. What type of book are you in the mood for today? Poetry, historical, educational, political? Don't do the political. Yeah, I don't know where to begin, actually. My first impression is that it's really laggy, giving me crazy input lag when I was trying to record. But it was fine when I stopped, but I can't stop because I need to make the video, so what a bummer. The first book I opened up was How Odors Came to Be by Puppy Eyes 15, because of course that's a thing. A whopping 4 pages about how ugly online daters are and how no one likes them. That's a trend you'll probably notice real fast. These things are kinda short. I have yet to find a book that even enters the double digits of pages, I think. Your guess is as good as mine for why this is, but I'd assume it's just Roblox authors aren't really able to stretch their topics out for very long. But hey, quality over quantity, right? So let's see some real highlights I've been able to track down in this establishment. Starting with History of Doge. Yep. Hashtag Doge for life. Lost top 8 memes de-doge.
All doge. Doge all day, every day, baby.
Ooh, we've got a book on how to use the Roblox forums properly. The Roblox forums. Can't wait to put those skills to use. After skimming through about 7 books at most, I got heavily distracted playing one of the built-in chess games with my friend Tony. And after doing this for who knows how long, we ended up getting into a stalemate and had to call it quits. So that was a waste of time, but I appreciate the extra activity option that this place provides. So back to the books, I decided to read This Place Is Now On Fire by Epic Rika, because as it turns out, there's some kind of free model in here that's infected with that one script that causes any instance of fire to become massive when touched. So you get a few friends that happen to be wearing particle hats, and congratulations, you've burned down the library. And then I glitched into this staff room with a bunch of other people because, of course, we're doing everything but reading right now. Back to reading, what have we got? How to Troll Like a Boss. A book full of animal puns. A super secret scary book in a cave that kills you when you close it. A book on mini modding, which is literally just half a page spelling out the definition of it. Egg lunch recipes. A story about a joke-telling girl that also lasts for half a page. A book about being famous, which is also just one page, and again, it just describes what it is, totally wasting what could have been a very interesting topic. So it was around this time that I realized that, while there are hundreds and hundreds of books in this building, what actually makes them impressive is just the number and nothing else, because the actual contents rarely surpass mediocrity. And much like any other Roblox group that has a focus on grammar in some way, like this does, these people sure do manage to get away with a lot of mistakes. So it was when I realized all that I also realized, why don't I just write a book of my own if the rest of them are so bad? And I'm stopping there for now, because I didn't finish it in time. So I began to briefly study the books provided in the lobby that detail the actual process of publishing your book. And I had a few ideas floating around in my head, such as literally publishing the script of this video as a book, but I wasn't able to decide on anything for a while. So I took to Twitter to ask my very cool followers for suggestions. I gotta stop hitting the microphone. None of these replies really helped. honestly. Make an autobiography on our non-existent band. No. Write about Bull Heaven, you know, maybe. Ways to torture a keyboard. No. Write a backstory for your persona. He just exists.
The state of liberalism in Russia.
What?
Publish the script for this video? Are you kidding me? That was my idea!
So the tweet didn't do me any good, so I went and made my own better idea. What if the book just wasn't readable at all? What I mean by that is, I did write an actual book, but I generated several nonsense versions of it, using an online gibberish generator, put it all together, and got my book. Before its destruction, the book used to be a commentary on the concept itself and its potential reception, and I do still have the original writing in my possession, but I'm not gonna share it, because that'd defeat the purpose. And also, I don't like how my typing looks when I'm forced to use grammar. So, yeah, don't look at it. So I sent that over to this person, who I'm going to black out because I don't want them getting harassed. And naturally, I got no response, because the library is too cowardly to handle my groundbreaking experimentation. But that's alright. I don't have to single-handedly save this game and its community with this very good idea! But in all seriousness, I've really enjoyed my time in the Roblox library. There was something weirdly satisfying about trying to look through as many books as possible and see what kind of hidden gems there may be in here. Like, how to understand women. Written by your local 13-year-old misogynist. Mediocrity and bad things aside, I really respect what they've got going here. It's really cool to see something like this where everyone can come together and make a thing and stuff, and I'm just trying not to be too cynical about that now, despite all the goofs I was doing before. And that's pretty much what I said in the real life bit at the end too. I thanked both Bordy and the Broken Headset for showing me a nice experimental project like this, and I threw them away, and I just kinda left the recording going. I was trying to get some field recordings or whatever so I could sample it because it was raining and all that, and I was just messing around with the headset some more. And later on, I started a separate recording where I was using my cane and stomping my feet to create strange rhythms and stuff. I don't know, it was weird, and I definitely would have gone on a lot longer if my camera's SD card hadn't run out of space. That's it, time for outro. This is the part where I'm like, oh man, I'm so sorry for not uploading for a month. And I'm like, oh man, I can't believe the video's not even 10 minutes despite the waiting time. But you know what? There's gonna be something very soon. I'm gonna do second channel stuff again, I hope. And I'm gonna do Super Doomspire next for the review after. I'm gonna start on that immediately after. It's gonna be very, very cool. Very cool and good.